Who knows what evil lurks in the heart of game? The Shadows Know.
Hi, I'm The Shadows Knows, and I'm back with another Let's Compare video. Tonight I'm going to compare the game Sonic Boom on the Commodore 64, the Atari ST, and the Commodore Amiga. And I'll start with the Commodore 64, and where's the Any key? Okay, I can press fire. Oh, this is ugly. And this is an arcade game, originally. And I think I did play this on main. Oh shit. It feels a little zoikish. Which means... fuck. But it feels a little bit like it's made with a shoot 'em up construction kit. And I really hate the background music. Okay, that's power up. Yeah, but very smooth scrolling. Movement also... oh shit. Movement also very fluent. Yeah, the bullets are sometimes a little bit hard to see. Yeah, but it's definitely playable. Oh, fuck. Okay, I try that again. Ah, but the background music is horrible. Oh, yeah. And no built-in auto fire. I cannot shoot the tank. Oh, I can shoot the tank. Oh, fuck. This is hard. And I bet I have some smart bomb or something like that with a space bar. But I can't really operate the space bar with my current setup. Yeah, it's not the worst shooter in the world, definitely not. Scrolling is too smooth for that. The horrible background music. Oh! And that's... it's very hard to see the bullets. And why is this bar on top of the screen? Is this a glitch? Ach, shit. Okay, that was the Commodore 64 version onto the Atari ST. Okay, back on the Atari ST. Yeah, and this is a cracked version on one disc. Oh, that's probably why it doesn't work. Great. I hope this glitch is... yeah, it's just in this one screen. So I don't bother. Scrolling is quite smooth. And the bullets are a little bit easier to see, but it's quite slow. Oh shit, come on. Yeah, but I think I've played worse on the SD. Oh shit, come on. I want to continue. Thank you. This is a very hard game. Last try. And I think it's, yes, it does slow down when there are a lot of objects moving on the screen. I'm really curious how the Amiga version looks like. If it's just a lazy port or if they actually did it properly. Oh shit! Yeah, besides the slowdowns, no problems with the graphics. It doesn't feel quite as responsive as the Commodore 64 version. Shit. Okay, last try. No, I'm not going to continue. I'm continuing on the Commodore Amiga. Okay, back with the Amiga. Yeah, and this is about the same that it should have looked on the Atari ST. No, it's not a proper port, it's a lazy port. Great. And I think the game is from 1990, not from 1987. I think 87 is the copyright of the arcade machine. But I think it does not slow down as much as the ST version. So maybe they did use a little of the Amiga features. Let's see. Not really sure about that. Yeah, I think I remember the arcade machine. At least I remember I played a shooter with some trains in it. And I don't think there are that many of those. So it probably has been... Ah, okay, that's the strange bar that I thought was a glitch on the Commodore 64. It's probably the power bar for the end boss. Holy shit. Shit. Yeah, I think the Amiga version is a little bit better than the ST version, but not much. Shit. But I still find the music annoying in all three versions. Sound effects are also nothing to write home about. They are quite an average shooter. I don't think I would have been mad if I had had this back in the days. Oh, I'm not going to continue. It's not good enough for that. Yeah, that was Sonic Boom. I hope you enjoyed this video and thanks for watching.